Marriage between cousins is taboo in some parts of the world, but in some cultures, it is perfectly acceptable and even preferable. About a century ago, marriages between cousins were common in many Western countries. So, why is there so much contention about marriages between cousins now? Is it just about the social discomfort it may cause, or are there scientifically proven consequences of such unions? Marriage between cousins is a practice that was common among many royal families in Europe. Many dynasties gave a lot of importance to the purity of bloodlines and married blood relatives to keep their family lines pure. This is a factor often cited as a cause for inbreeding and genetic diseases in royals. For instance, Charles II of Spain was the last king of the Habsburg dynasty and was best known for his physical disabilities that are speculated to be due to genetic disorders. His ancestors mostly married within the same pool of blood relatives for generations, and his parents were uncle and niece. Charles suffered from a number of genetic disorders and was short, lame, epileptic, senile, and bald before the age of 35. He died childless at the age of 38. According to research, marriages between cousins could be dangerous for their children as they share the same gene pool. According to a study by the National Society of Genetic Counselors, a child of first cousins could have 4-7% risk of having a birth defect. Usually, a risk of birth defect in children of unrelated individuals is 3-4%. For such a small increase in risk percentage, why are marriages between cousins considered so risky? A marriage between cousins is like playing Russian roulette with genes. It may not cause any defects in the children of such couples, or it may cause severe genetic disorders and birth defects. The risk is highest among the children of first cousins. Some studies have shown that the risk of genetic disorders halves in second cousins and reduces exponentially in third and fourth cousins. To understand this, it is necessary to understand that gene defects can lie dormant in people and they may not themselves manifest the disease but just be carriers. Now, if a carrier produces kids with a non-carrier, then there is no risk of the gene defect getting activated in their child. But when a carrier marries someone with the same gene defect, then their child has a high risk of getting two copies of the same gene defect that could activate the disorder. If a person marries his first cousin and then their child marries his first cousin, then it becomes a recipe for disaster. It means that the children are being produced in the same gene pool, recycling the old and possibly dangerous ones till they sit in a combination that leads to genetic disorders.